We just wanted to do a public service announcement on how to make your house a harder target for thieves. A lot of the time you have snowbirds going away during the winter, and those abandoned houses cause issues for us, because what is happening is thieves are coming around, they're seeing houses are abandoned, and they're targeting them. I highly suggest you get somebody to stay in your home. I know a lot of students like that idea, and it's just the safest because you know that somebody's going to be in your home. Thieves don't like to break into homes where there's high risk, though. They like to break into the easy homes. They know they're not going to be confronted, and there's not going to be a possibility of them getting caught. A few tips to make your home a harder target would be to take care of your property. So shovel your walks, make sure you're bringing your mail in. If you know a package is arriving, make sure someone's going to be home, or you can come home and lunch and grab it. The biggest things, though, is making sure your windows and doors are locked. That is the number one thing. Thieves go for easy targets, so if you're leaving your garage door unlocked or back door of your house unlocked, it makes it easy for them to just sneak inside, grab a few things, and run. In terms of break and enters, it's been pretty consistent from 2018-2019, but we're just seeing a lot of detached garage break and enters are increasing right now. And typically, you know, bicycles are taken, tools, but things add up quickly. Break and enter where a suspect has time, you can see up to $70,000 worth of items taken, personal items. I would say on average it's about $40,000. Things add up very quickly. Typically jewelry, electronics, art, family heirlooms, and personal financial data and documents are targeted.